Hello everyone. So in this video we'll be seeing about some of the types of the crucible furnaces. So in the previous video we saw about one classification of a crucible furnace, which is the coke fired furnace. So with the help of the coke it is getting ignited, and the heat produced it helps in melting the raw material. So in this video we are going to see about the next type of the furnace based on the fuel used, that is the oil fired furnace. So with the help of the oil the furnace is get ignited and the raw material is melted. So in this type of furnace the crucible kept on the pedestal, it's charged with the ingot. So the ingot is nothing but the raw material that we are going to melt. So this raw material is placed in the crucible and a burner is situated at the bottom on one side. So the valves are provided to control the amount of air and oil supplied to the burner so that flames can be controlled. The oil from the burner is ignited and the desired flame is controlled by valves. After the metal melts and attains the desired superheat, the crucible is taken out and the molten metal is treated and poured. So in this diagram you can see this is the arrangement of an oil fired furnace. So there is a refractory lining inside which there is a pedestal. Above the pedestal is the crucible kept. And the raw materials to be melted is placed in the crucible, that is nothing but the ingot. So here is a burner where you can see the oil supply and the air is also supplied. So the burner is switched on, the oil is supplied and the blower is also given to exaggerate the heat produced. So this, it reaches the crucible and a gas form is produced, which produces a too much of heat, and this heat produced it results in melting of the raw material. So the there are two valves to control the fuel flow and also the air from the blower. So the gases it produced it circulates the crucible and it escapes through the outlet. So there is a refractory which is made up of a fire bricks and the crucible, and so this is the arrangement of an oil fired furnace. So next one is about the gas fired furnace. The fire is created at the bottom using waste or a coke or a wood, etc. Gas is blown through the burner. This will create a flame and it heats the inside of the lining. The burner is switched off and the crucible with ingots is placed. The burner is switched on, flame will sweep around the crucible. So when the burner is switched on, the flames it surrounds the crucible and the flame is used to melting. Once the metal it reaches the desired temperature, the burner is switched off and the crucible is taken out and the molten metal is treated and poured. So this is the arrangement of a gas fired furnace. So this is also kept below the ground level, and here there is a lid through which the there is a provision for the hot gases to escape, and also by opening the lid we can take the crucible out. So here you can see there is a refractory lining and above the pedestal block there is a crucible placed in which the raw material to be melted is placed. So this refractory lining it's covered with a steel shell, and there is a provision for the gas to enter, gas and the air to enter. So when the gas is sent inside along with the air, it burns and it creates some gases. So this hot gases it surrounds the crucible and heat the crucible. So when the maximum temperature is reached, the metal placed inside this crucible starts to get melted, and the left out gases it escapes through the vent that is provided in the lid. So once the raw material it reaches to the molten state, the lid is opened and the crucible is taken out. After removing the slag, it is poured into the ladle and it is taken for the casting process. So this is about the gas fired furnace. So the next one that we are going to see is the resistant furnace. So resistant furnace, this is the indirect type of resistant furnace. It consists of a current carrying coil inside the refractory bricks. The crucible with ingots is charged, is kept in the furnace on the pedestal and lid is closed. So this is a kind of crucible furnace only, but here instead of giving a air or a fuel, current is given as a source of heat. The crucible is kept on the pedestal and the lid is closed. Current is switched on. The temperature of the furnace is controlled by a temperature controller. So if the temperature is too much, it may explode. So in order to control the temperature, there is a temperature controller. The melting, it starts slowly. After completion of melting, the lid is opened, so the crucible is taken out and heating takes place due to the resistance offered by the coil of on the principle I2RT. So this is nothing but the formula used to calculate the heat generated. So the heat generated is calculated with the formula of I2RT. So this resistance is nothing but the opposition of the current. So this is calculated with the principle of heat generated. So that this type of furnace is normally used for melting non-ferrous alloys. So this is particularly used for melting the non-furnace alloys. So this diagram, it shows about the resistant furnace. So you can see here this arrangement is similar to that of the previously shown, either it may be a crucible coke fired furnace or a gas fired furnace. So everything will be in the similar shape. The only difference is there will be an outer source of providing the heat, but here there is a resistance coil which is placed inside the refractory lining itself. So inside a steel shell, the refractory lining is placed. In the refractory lining, the resistance coil is also placed. When the current is switched on, this resistance coil, it produces heat which heats the crucible place. So this crucible is placed upon the pedestal and the raw material is placed inside the crucible. So when the current is switched on, the resistance coil, it produces heat which helps in heating up the crucible. So once the crucible is heated to the desired temperature, the raw material gets melted. So the gases, it escape though the heat current is supplied. When the raw material is heated, there will be some smoke that's coming out of the crucible. So that is that escapes out through the vent present in the lid. And once that process is completed, the electric supply, the current is switched off and the lid is removed and the crucible is taken out and the metal is treated. So this is about the different types of crucible furnace that we are using for the casting process. Usually this crucible, all the furnaces are placed below the ground level, but only this resistant furnace is placed above the ground level. Okay, so this is about the different types of crucible furnaces. Thank you.